Now, Russia has resumed sending gas exports through its biggest pipeline to Europe after a 10-day maintenance period. Pipeline operator Nord Stream AG says deliveries restarted Thursday, providing some relief for the continent. Amid growing tensions over Russia's war in Ukraine, German officials had feared that the pipeline might not reopen at all. European countries have been storing up fuel supplies before the winter. The European Commission also urged its member countries to reduce their demand for natural gas amid reduced Russian oil exports.
In case that we have a situation that deteriorates, like the full disruption of Russian gas, we trigger an EU alert overall for the European Union. We are asking the member states to reduce by 15% the gas consumption.
Nord Stream says restoring flows to the levels requested may take some time. Ranil Wickremesinghe has been sworn in as the new president of crisis-hit Sri Lanka. The six-time prime minister took his oath of office at the country's tightly guarded parliament complex Thursday. The brief ceremony was due to be broadcast live on television, but was inexplicably cut off moments before it got underway. An investigation into the matter is now being conducted. Wickremesinghe is an ally of ousted leader Gotabaya Rajapaksa, who fled the country and resigned last week. Protesters earlier set Wickremesinghe's residence on fire and demanded that he step down with Rajapaksa. As president, he now faces the task of taking charge of the bankrupt country. The Asian Development Bank slashes its growth forecast for developing Asia for 2022. It now expects the region's GDP growth to slow to 4.6% from April's 5.2%. The ADB cited the growing fallout from the Ukraine-Russia conflict for the downgrade. But the ADB is more optimistic about its growth outlook for the Philippines. It predicts the country's GDP growth to hit 6.5% this year, higher than its previous forecast of 6%. Now, the ADB says growth will be fueled by relaxed COVID restrictions, expanded vaccination coverage, and household consumption. Its forecast is within the government's growth target of 6.5% to 7%, or 7.5%. Higher water rates loom for residents of Metro Manila and nearby provinces as water concessionaires bat for rate increases in a bid to offset costs. Alvin El Chico reports.
Consumers may need to brace for higher water rates next year as the MWSS Regulatory Office begins its rate rebasing process covering years 2023 to 2027. Wednesday's public consultation in Manila was for customers of Maynilad. MWSS Chief Regulator Patrick T. declines to divulge the actual increase sought by Maynilad, but an official of the water concessionaire says it has already spent 80 billion pesos for various projects that need to be recovered through higher water tariffs.
Yun yung hindi pa namin na kukolekta sa mga para pambayad dun sa mga projects na yun, na nakukuha yun sa tubig na binibenta. Kaya dapat i-balance yun. So, ano man yung makukolekta, babibenta pang tubig, kailangan yung tariff nun is enough para mabawi yung projects.
Yeah. Otherwise,
nagpaluwal kami ng hindi nabawi.
The regulatory body says Manila Water has already spent 20 billion pesos for projects, which it also wants to recover from its customers. But these figures will still have to go through stringent evaluation by the regulator and its consultant.
Given the extent ng dapat gawin pa to sustain the development, maaaring may karagdagan kasi may marami ka pang expansion gagawin eh. Kailangan kasi proactive ang concessionaire to meet any increase in demand, hindi yung reactive.
Kaya nga po, we hired a consultant na para po i-check po yung books ng ating concessionaires at pag-aaralan po rin din natin yan to make sure that tama po yun at only those that are prudent and efficient ang pwede lang ipasa sa ating consumers.
The regulator vows to soften the impact on consumers in case the rate hike becomes hefty.
If it's going to go up, the MWSSRO will be here to make sure that hindi po natin ibibigla ang ating mga consumers at idahandahan po natin, itatranch po natin yan. Hindi po natin papayagan na one-time na adjustment.
There are also issues that need to be resolved in the revised concession agreement made during the Duterte administration before the new contracts kick in. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.